Hello and welcome to part three of our training series. In this webinar, we are going to cover how to upload a qEEG brain map to newmindmaps.com. I will be showing everybody this two different ways. First, we're going to go through and talk about how to upload a map through the NewMind clinical software. And this would be if you have the pro subscription. And then we will follow that up by showing everybody how to upload directly through newmindmaps.com. And this would be if you have a basic subscription. Right, so first thing we need to do is to get our software up. And from the home screen, we're going to go to brain mapping. And since we're uploading a brain map, we'll come over and click on the right button that says upload brain map. Okay. So the first thing the software is going to want to know is who is the client that this map belongs to. So we'll click for our dropdown. We'll pick our test client. And then I'm going to come over to the right side. And next thing it wants to know is the map type. So again, anybody using the NewMind 4 or 20 channel amplifiers, we do a 19 channel full Q, or sorry, 19 point full Q. And then they need to know the amplifier type. So we have the NewMind 4 channel, the NewMind 20 channel, and then you can also choose from a BrainMaster Discovery, BrainMaster 4 channel, or a BrainMaster 2 channel. And the test I did was with a NewMind 4 channel, so I'm going to select that. Most of the time, you are going to be creating a new report. Over here, there is an option to add to an existing report. So this would be if maybe you had already uploaded an eyes closed, and now you need to go back and upload an eyes open to that same EEG set. You would choose add to an existing and then pick the report name that you need to upload to. I'm going to choose create a new report. And for the report name, it doesn't need to include their name or if it's eyes closed or eyes open, because that's all getting uploaded together. Instead, what we want here is just a name that helps let us know when we log into the database what map this was. So I'd like to just use first map, second map, third map. You don't have to do it that way. You can name these however you want, but I will show you when we get into the database where this name's going to end up showing up so you can understand a little better. So then you can choose your names properly. So this is the first map. They want to know the map date. So we can click on the calendar, select the date. And then if they had completed any of the surveys, which they should have, you can select those so it ties those into this map. Keep in mind, we generally have them fill out new surveys every time we remap them. So pay attention to the dates if this is their second or third map, so you can get the right surveys for the right map. Next, we are going to come over and select the EEG files to create this report. So I'm going to start here with the top browse button under eyes open. And here we can see the software has taken us right to our client's folder. And it's also filtered out everything that we didn't ask for. So we were browsing for eyes open. So the database has selected just to show us the two eyes open recordings. This top one is the one we want to upload to create our map, because this is the file that's been auto-artifacted. The file below it is the recording with all the artifact. And the second file here that I've got highlighted, that's the file we would use at newmindmaps.com if we chose to edit the artifact out ourselves. I'm going to go ahead and double click on this top one, and we can see it's placed that file where it belongs. Then we are going to click the browse button for eyes closed. And again, it's filtering out, only showing us eyes closed. So I want that top one that's been artifacted. Okay, so we've got all of our information in. Software knows who the client is. In fact, it was a 19-point full queue recorded on a new Mine 4 channel amp. We've given our report a name and the date. We've got our files selected. So now we're going to come to the upper right and click on upload to new mind maps. Okay, so once your file has successfully uploaded, it will come back to the upload brain map screen. If you needed to upload additional reports for other clients, you could continue the process we just went through. If this was the only client you needed to upload, you could back out to your home screen. Now, what I'm going to do now is show everybody how we are going to upload directly to newmindmaps.com. If you only have the basic subscription, it doesn't give you the linkability that the pro subscription does. So once we get logged into newmindmaps.com, we can go to My Clients. We'll open up the client page. And then we're going to click on the Brain Maps tab. And here you can see the EEG set that we just uploaded directly from the software. And this is that name that I was talking about. So here we can see it's just telling us it's first map. So it just kind of makes it easy, in my opinion, to know which map is which when you're trying to view your reports. So to manually upload these to the database, we would have to start by clicking the Add EEG Set button. And then it needs a set name. So that's that name we were just looking at. So let's assume this is now the second map. Okay. And then again, if they've done the surveys, which they should have done by now, we can link those in. Map date, if it wasn't recorded today, we have the calendar, we can change that. And we need to know the brain map size. So again, we are doing a 19-point full QEEG. Next thing the database needs to know is the brain map file type. So if, again, if you're using NewMind's equipment, it's going to be an EDF file. You also have the option of BrainMaster, NeuroGuide, BioExplorer. And then this option would be if you decided to edit the EDF file yourself to remove artifact. When you do that through the EEG editing tool, it will save as a CSV file. So you would choose this one. We are going to do the EDF file. It needs to know the amplifier type. So again, we recorded with a 4-channel NewMind amplifier. And then the last option is if you would like the client's name to be printed on the report. By default, this is set to no. It kind of helps with HIPAA laws. That way, if you have a printed report laying out somewhere, that client's name's not going to be on the report. The only identifying markers that would show up by selecting no would be their client number. So that's all you would have there to let you know who that report belongs to. So I'm just going to leave that at no. I'm going to click Add. Here we can see our EEG set's been created. So now I have some upload map buttons. So we're going to start here under Eyes Closed, click the Upload Map button. Now we need to choose our file. So we'll click that Choose File button. Now, I've already manually uploaded before, so it is coming directly to the folder. If this is the first time you've ever uploaded from the computer that you will be using, you need to find that Brain Maps folder. When you install our software, it will automatically place a shortcut on your desktop for brain map recording. So you could simply go to desktop and find that folder. So here we see brain map shortcuts. So we could open that up. I think everyone should actually know where this shortcut is located. So let's go ahead and go find that so you can see where it's at. So on the left side here in File Explorer, if I click on where it says Windows C, or you could start with this PC and then open up the Windows C drive. Once you're in the Windows C drive, the next thing you would need to do is double click on Program Files x86. And then you're going to scroll down till you find New Mind Training Folder. We're going to double click on that. Then we're going to click on the data file. And then we'll double click where it says EDF. And then we're going to double click again on brain maps. And now we'll see our names. So we're going to double click for that test client. And there's our four files. So again, these two files here are the eyes closed and eyes open that have had the artifact removed through the software. These two files contain all the artifact. So we were uploading for eyes closed. So I'm going to double click on the eyes closed EDF file here. And I'm going to choose upload. All right, now I can go over and click on the eyes open upload map button. And we'll click choose file. And eyes open with the artifact removed is right here. So we'll double click on that and click the upload button. All right, so you'll notice we didn't automatically get a view report button here, but our buttons now say to edit the EEG. The file we chose has already been edited through our Pro software. However, we still need to click on edit EEG. And then because I know that all this data should have all the artifact removed, I'm just going to click select all data. And depending on how long your recording was, will determine how long this process is going to take. If you did a standard, 1 or 2 minutes, shouldn't take too long. But if you chose maybe a 5-minute recording, per location, you can expect it to take a little bit longer. So we'll just patiently wait for this information to be processed. And then we can continue on with the eyes open, and then we'll be done. Okay, so now I'm going to come over and click on the edit EEG button under eyes open. Again, I'm just going to click select all data, and then we'll wait for this to upload. All right, so now that is how you manually upload your recordings directly to New Mind Maps if you have the basic software. Next part we will be recording is how to build a training plan. So in part 4, what we're going to discuss is how to take the protocols that come up on your client's report and build these in the New Mind clinical software so we can go ahead and actually train our patients. Thank you for taking some time out of your day and joining us on this training series. We'll see you all again soon. Take care.